This video follows on from the video which gave an overview of how to set up a TotalStation using the Setup app. That is, how to position and orientate the TotalStation. This video will describe how to set up a TotalStation using the height transfer method. The height transfer method should be used in the following case. If the point over which you will position the TotalStation is known, the orientation of the TotalStation is already correct, or you don't care what is the orientation, and you simply need to establish the height of the TotalStation by measuring to one or more target points. Before completing this setup, it is possible to look at the quality of the measurements to the targets and exclude any measurements which may be considered wrong or inaccurate. So let's run through the method. As always, move the job we want to use to the centre of the carousel. This means the setup information, for example, the instrument height, the target points used and so on, will be stored to this job. Now tap on the Setup app, choose the height transfer method and press OK. And we access the Choose Setup Point panel. Here we can choose from where the setup point shall be selected. The options are from a job, enter new point, GS Smart Station and last used. If you choose from job, then any point from any job can be selected. This is useful since it means if your control points are stored in a different job, you can select a point from that job. Enter new point is obvious. In the next panel, it would be possible to enter the point ID and coordinates of a new point. The GS Smart Station option is really cool. This allows the location of the TotalStation to be measured using a GS sensor sitting on top of the TotalStation. And last use setup can be useful if you have returned to exactly the same location as the day before, for example. We will choose to enter a new point, press OK, enter the point ID, and enter the known coordinates. So now we need to measure to the first target point. We can select it from the list using the point ID or select it from the 3D viewer. We need to enter the height of the target, we aim to the target, and then press measure. This will measure to the target and store the measurement. You may notice that the calculate key is now visible. This is because we have measured the target point and therefore the height of the TotalStation can be computed. We will, however, measure one more target point. This may strengthen the heighting of the TotalStation. We measure to the second target point. We again select the target point, enter the target height, aim to the target, and then press measure. Again, the measurement is made and stored. We won't measure a third point, but instead compute the setup. That is, calculate the height of the TotalStation by pressing calculate. Depending on how accurately the target points were measured and or the correctness of the target points themselves, we may get a message informing about the quality of the heighting. In the results page tab, we can see the height which has been computed. The difference in height shows the difference between the elevation of the TotalStation based on the point over which the TotalStation was set up and the computed height. That is the height based on the measurements to the target points. We can see the old and the new height and tick the box if we want to use the new height. If we want to measure to more target points, we can press Add Target. On the Setup page tab, the instrument height can be seen and re-entered if it had been forgotten or a mistake made earlier. The setup point can be given a point code if needed. The current PPM is shown as a reminder as to what PPM or scale factor is being used. On the Targets page tab, the individual measurements to the targets can be seen. Here it is possible to choose which of the measurements we want to use. If you are using or connected to an imaging TotalStation, then the Camera page tab allows you to capture an image and link it to the station. In the Plot page tab, it is possible to see a 3D view of the setup. This can be useful to visually check the setup and the location of the target points is correct. Once you are happy that all information is entered, then press Set. This will store all setup information to the job. If you're using an imaging TotalStation, you will be asked if you want to capture a panoramic image. and then you will return to the home screen. The instrument is set up and you can get to work. So in summary, the height transfer method is the method to use when you know the point over which you will position the total station, and you simply want to compute the height of the total station based on one or more measurements to target points. Please do watch the other videos to learn more about the individual methods, and thanks for watching.